start compound interest. We already discussed the formula of that. Let us revise it. First formula, A equal to P in bracket 1 plus I raised to N. I is a rate of interest, N is number of years. P is a principal amount, A is the total amount. From total amount, if we subtract principal amount, we get compound interest. Third, for first year, compound interest and simple interest are same. For second year, for first 2 years, not second year, for first 2 years, the difference between compound interest and simple interest is PI square. For first 3 years, what is the formula any of you know? Formula. What is the formula for first 3 years? What is the formula for first 3 years? PI square in bracket I plus 3. Now please learn this. Sixth. If interest is calculated half yearly, which is also known as semi-annually, then we have to divide I by 2 and we have to multiply N by 2. N is number of years. Similarly, for quarterly, you have to divide I by 4 and you have to multiply N by 4. And for monthly, we have to divide I by 12 and we have to multiply N by 12. Then there is a formula of depreciation. This is the formula of depreciation. Here, scrap value equal to cost of the machine into 1 minus I raised to N, where I is the rate of depreciation. And there is one another formula of effective rate of interest. Effective rate of interest, formula for that is 1 plus I upon M whole raised to M minus 1, where M equal to 2 for half yearly. If interest is calculated half yearly, then we have to take M equal to 2. M equal to 4 for quarterly. And M equal to 12 for monthly. So now let us start examples depends on this. See question number 11. It's a very simple question. P is given, R is given, N is given. You have to find out amount and compound interest. So, simple question is there. A equal to P in bracket 1 plus I raised to N is the formula. P is 1000. Rate of interest is 5%. So, 1 plus I means 1 plus 5% means 1 plus 0.05. That means 1.05. So you can write directly 1.05. And number of years, 4. So do the calculation and tell me the answer. 1.05 raised to 4 into 1000. What is the answer? What is the answer? Do the calculation, be fast. 1.05 raised to 4 into 1000.
1215.50625.
From that, so this is the, you can write 1215.50 or 51. And from that, you can subtract 1000. So you will get 215.50 or 51. Both are valid. So this is the answer. 1215. So A is the answer. Question number 12. Rupees 100 will becomes after 20 years at 5% per annum compound interest amount of. So if we invest 100 rupees at 5% rate of interest, so after the end of 20 years, what is the amount? What is the amount? And the rate of interest is calculated compoundly. So this is also a very simple question. 12. Same formula. P is 100. 5% means 1.05 raised to 20. Do the calculation, you will get the answer.
265.329.
So 265.32, that is the answer. Roughly you can say that 265.5. Question number 13. The question, the effective rate of interest. Here we have to find out effective rate of interest corresponding to a nominal rate of 3% per annum payable half yearly. So we have to use the formula of effective rate of interest. 1 plus I upon M whole raised to M minus 1. This is the formula. So here effective rate of interest is 1 plus our nominal rate of interest is 3%. So I is 0.03. Because of half yearly, M is 2. Whole raised to 2 minus 1. Once again, because of half yearly, M is 2 and I is rate of interest, nominal rate of interest, that is 0.03. So here if we calculate, we get 0.015, the whole square minus 1. So it is 1.015, the whole square minus 1. What is it? Final answer. Multiply that by 100. So we get 3.0225%. So nominal rate of interest is 3%. And effective rate of interest is 3.0225% per annum. That is the final answer. 14. A machine is depreciated at the rate of 20% on reducing balance. The cost of machine, original cost of the machine is 1 lakh rupees. And scrap value, ultimate scrap value is 30,000. The effective life of the machine is effective life. That means we have to find out N, cost of the machine, 1 lakh. Here C equal to 1 lakh. Scrap value is 30,000. Rate of depreciation is 20%. And we have to find out value of N. Cost of the machine is 1 lakh, scrap value is 30,000, rate of depreciation 20%. So what is the N? That is the question. So use the formula S equal to C in bracket 1 minus I raised to N. Now, this is 30,000. This is 1 lakh. 1 minus 0.20, 20% means 0.20. N is unknown. Take this 1 lakh in another side. So 30,000 divided by 1 lakh equal to, this is 0.80 raised to n. So 30,000 divided by 1 lakh is 0.3 equal to 0.80 or 0.8, it's same thing, 0.8 raised to n. Now we have to find out the value of n. So for that we have to take log on both the sides.
5.
We have to take log, taking log on both the sides. So we get log 0.3 equal to log 0.8 raised to n. So we get log 0.3 equal to, we have a rule of logarithm, log m raised to n, anything raised to n, you can write n times log n. So you can write this is n times log 0.8. Now this you can write log 0.3 means 3 divided by 10. This you can write log 8 divided by 10. There is one other rule of logarithm, log m upon n. The formula for that is log m minus log n. So you can write this as log 3 minus log 10 equal to n in bracket log 8 minus log 10. Log 3, value of log 3 is given in the exam. Value of log 3 is given in the exam. So just you have to use that value. No need to use log table also in exam. Log 10 is always 1. Once again, value of log 3 is given in exam. And you also know that how to find out that value by using log table. Okay, log 8. You can calculate log 8. That is 0.9031. That is also given in the question. So don't worry about that. In exam, it is given. You can use log table to find out this value also. Now subtract this. Tell me the answer. Minus 0.5229. Check it. So our n equal to minus 0.5229 divided by minus 0.0969. What is the answer? Final answer.
Minus 5.3962.
It is minus minus plus. So final answer should be positive. What is the final answer?
5.39
years. That is the final answer. Or you can say that 5.4 years. So n equal to 5.4. That is the final answer. So 5.4 years approximately, that is the final answer. So here you require to know about logarithm up to certain extent. I know that you know it very well. So no need to waste time. Let us continue. 15. A is given, N is given, R is given. And it is given that compound interest payable half yearly, and you have to find out the value of P. So because it's half yearly, A, there is no change in A. A is 1,000. Because it's half yearly, we have to divide rate of interest by 2. So here I equal to 0.06 divided by 2, that means 0.03. See, if once again, if because half yearly is given, we have to divide I by 2 and we have to multiply N by 2, means number of years by 2. So here there are 2 years. So we have to multiply it by 2, so we get 4. And the question is, what is P? Now it is simple question. A equal to P in bracket 1 plus I raised to N. This is the formula. A is what? 1000. P is unknown. This is 3% means 0.03 plus 1. That means 1.03 raised to 4. So 1000 equal to P. What is the calculation? 1.04 whole raised to 4. Do the calculation. Be fast. Do the calculation.
1.1255.
Once again. 1.1255. Okay. 1000 divided by 1.1255. Please don't write in message. Don't write answer in message. Unmute yourself and then tell me the answer. What is P? 888.49 or 888.5. So we have answer, or you can consider this as a final answer. 888.80. Roughly it is correct. Okay, question number 16. The population of a town increases every year by 2%. So rate of growth is 2% of the population at the beginning of that year. Number of years by which the total increase of population be 40%. So once again, we have to find out the value of N here. Rate of growth is given 2%. And it is given that in how many years it will increase by 40%, and we don't know the population at present. So because we don't know population at present, let us assume population at present is 100. So the question is, when it will increase 40%? So we have to add 40% in that. So our A is 140. Why it is 140? 40% of 100 is 40, that we have to add in our original population, so it becomes 140. And here we have to find out, I is given 2%, and we have to find out value of N. So rate of growth is 2%, it is given. Population, see, number of years by which the total increase of population be 40%. So we have to find out in how many years total population will increase by 40%. So we don't know actual population, so we assume it is 100. You can assume any number, no problem, and add 40% in that number, that becomes your A, and I is 0.02, and we have to find out value of N. So use the formula, A equal to P in bracket 1 plus I raised to N. So 140 equal to 100 in bracket 1.02 raised to N. Divide by 100, so we get 1.4 equal to 1.02 raised to N. Now here also you can use log. Log 1.04 equal to log 1.02 raised to N. So we get here log 1.4 equal to N times log 1.02. So N equal to log 1.4 divided by log 1.02, and the value of log 1.4 and log 1.02 is given in the question. So don't worry about that. 1.4 the log value for that is 0.1461. 0.1416 or 61, let us check it. 61. And 1.02 log is 0.0086. 0.0086. In exam, it is given in the paper itself, so no problem at all for this. Do the calculation, you will get the answer. Tell me the answer. 16.98 or you can say that roughly 17 years. So it's required 17 years for increment of 40% population if rate of growth is 2%. So 17 years, that is the final answer. Question number 17. The difference between compound interest and simple interest on a certain sum of money invested for 3 years at 6% is given. What is the principal amount? Sum means principal amount. So the difference is given and it is for 3 years. So we know that for first 3 years, CI minus SI equal to PI square in bracket I plus 3. This is the formula that we already discussed in our first lecture, how to obtain this formula. A year difference is 110.16. P is unknown. Rate of interest is 6%. So you have to write 0.06. Square is there, and then 0.06 plus 3. So 110.16 equal to P in bracket 0.0036, and this is 3.06. Multiply these two value and tell me the value. Tell me the answer. Multiply these two, 0.0036 and 3.06. Tell me the value.
0.0110.
Once again, please.
0.0110116.
Now do the calculation. So you will get 10,000 because it's almost same. So 10,000, that is the final answer for question number 17. 18. The useful life of machine is estimated to be 10 years. So the life of the machine is 10 years. Cost is 10,000. Rate of depreciation is 10%. What is the scrap value? That is a question. So it's a simple question. If you know the formula, what is the formula? Any of you know the formula? Be fast. Which formula we have to apply here? It is a question of depreciation. Cost is 10,000. Rate of depreciation 10%. Number of years 10. What is the scrap value? That is a question. What is the formula? Be fast.
S is equals to C into 1 minus I raised to N.
Correct. This is the formula. C is 10,000. Rate of interest is, sorry, depreciation is 10%. And number of year is 10. So 10,000 into 0.9 raised to 10. Do the calculation. 0.9 raised to 10 into 10,000. 0.9 raised to 10 into 10,000. Final answer. Be fast. 0.9 raised to 10 into 10,000. So 3486.78. 3486.78, that is the final answer. 3486.78. 19. The effective rate of interest corresponding to nominal rate is 7% per annum converted quarterly. So here we have to find out effective rate of interest, and nominal rate of interest is given 7% and quarterly is given. What is the formula? Any of you know the formula of effective rate of interest? Be fast. Which formula we have to use? Be fast. The formula is 1 plus I upon M whole raised to M minus 1. Here rate of interest is given and quarterly is given. Rate of interest is 7% and quarterly means M equal to 4. So just put values. So 1 plus 0.07 divided by 4 whole raised to 4 minus 1. So 1 plus, what is the calculation? 0.07 divided by 4. So 0.0175 raised to 4. So it is 1.0175 raised to 4 minus 1. So plus 1 raised to 4 and minus 1. So 0.0718 means 7.18%, that is the final answer. 7.18%. Now try to find out the solution of question number 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26. Okay, up to 24. From 25, it is the example of annuity. So we will discuss in our next lecture. So this is enough for today. If you have any question, you can ask your doubt.